He is the creator and sustainer of all the worlds. Whether those worlds are known, he is the sustainer of all the worlds. Whether those worlds are known or unknown.
Hi, welcome to Patrick's Tech Show. I'm Patrick John. Today we have a Europower PMP6000 audio board. It doesn't come on anymore. When you try to turn it on,
nothing happening, there's no power.
Some LEDs will blink. I am going to show you how to deassemble the audio board now. You don't really have to remove many screws. Starting with the front, you just have to... Starting with the front of the audio board, you'll see two sets of screws on the left, in the middle, and on the right. On the left, you want to remove the left screw. On the middle, you want to remove the left screw. And on the right, you want to remove the right screw. There are also six screws on the top that you're going to want to remove. There are three on the left and three on the right. On the back of the unit, you're going to see at the top six screws going across. You're going to want to remove the bottom screw of each set. And now that you've removed all those screws, you should be able to lift it up a little. It's still going to be tied down by two cables that you gotta be able to reach in and unattach. And voila. So because of the flashing LED, I assume the problem was one of these capacitors. So I replaced them and I marked them on the top so I would remember what I replaced. And that was not the problem. And then I downloaded and printed out this schematic for the Europower PMP6000, which you can find if you Google search. And I got desperate, and I just started following the voltage and making little marks. And then I noticed after the transformer, I had no voltage. Well, on the other side of that transformer, there's a whole bunch of diodes. So I went down the line of diodes with my meter. And what do you know? Diode 19 was shorted. Okay, so I'd like to show you how to check your diodes. So, if you have a multimeter, you go to the diode setting. And if your diode is fine, you'll hear on When you have one lead on one side and one on the other, you'll hear a little beep. And you'll... Oh, sorry, I went off the component. And then you'll see a little bit of voltage go one way. And then if you go the opposite way, you'll see an open load. Now, let me show you how that short looks. You hear that sound? So the next thing I did was I got online and I went to mouser.com and I ordered and I looked up MBRS1100TR, which was obsolete, but they had a replacement on there, so I got that. Diode 19. Diode 19. Diode 19. Diode 19. A diode is a component known as a semiconductor. It controls the flow of electrons into one direction. Now to unsolder this, you're gonna wanna be very careful. Because it's a tight squeeze in there and you don't want to bump other components. It would be very easy to brush against that capacitor. Gotta be very careful. And I will get that little sucker out with a pair of pliers, if you can find some that fit in there. Oh boy. Hi. Bingo. And there it is, folks. Now, I don't know about you, but now that we're probably halfway there and we've discovered what the problem is, well, I don't know about you, but at this point, I like to have a victory snack. And today's victory snack is Ants on a Log. And Ants on a Log is also a great power snack. It has a lot of protein from the peanut butter, so it would be really good for before or after a workout. And I made that with Dahl's fresh celery, Peanut Delight natural creamy peanut butter, and sun-made California raisins. So you'll get your new diode in a really little package like this. Go ahead and get some scissors and cut that out of there. And you'll notice on the surface mount diode, there'll be a line. There'll be a line on one end of the surface mount diode. Make sure that corresponds with where the line was on the old diode. The next thing I like to do is I like to put that diode in the pliers, put that where it needs to be in the circuit. Get my soldering iron. And once again, you want to make sure you got that line indicator on there facing where it should be. All right, now we're at the very exciting part. Now we get to put this lid back on and see what happens. Wow. And because I want to see very quickly, I'm not going to go through all the trouble of, finalizing it. I'm just going to loosely put it on and find my power cable and plug it in here and hit power. And guess what? It works! Wow! Now that is a refreshing sight. Just look at it. And now if I push an AFL button, the light stays on. It doesn't blink. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something and that this helped you. Now, if you want, you can watch me for the next couple of minutes. I'm going to do a victory dance.